Hi, my name is Freedom. Today I'm going to show you how to grab the Google Map 3D models into Blender. So before we start, you need to prepare all this software. First, you download the Blender. This is the latest version 2.83. Make sure you download the Blender. This is an installer. After you download it, you install into your computer. Then you should be able to have a Blender here. Alright, the next software you need to have is the RenderDoc. Come to this website, renderdoc.org. You download the installer and then install into your computer. After you install it, after you download and install, you should have a shortcut here, RenderDoc. So for this time, I drag down this shortcut. I drag into the desktop just to convenient for me. Right click. Find file location. So now I copy this and paste here. The next step, you need to prepare this, the map models importer. This is a Blender plugin. You come to this website, github.com. Okay, this website, I will copy for you this website. Later, I will just put below the video, in this YouTube video, you find the description of the video at the bottom, then you copy and paste, you can get this. Download, click here, then download the zip file. After you download the zip file, now I already finished download. After you download it, you extract this folder. This is a zip file, you just need to right click, extract all, click extract. So now you have an extra folder because it extract from here. So you open this folder, double click another folder here, Blender. Okay, these are the plugin. So you back to here. Again, I demonstrate again. After you extract it, you open this folder, double click this under Blender. So you need to copy this folder, copy. Then where to paste? Come here, Blender. You search the Blender here, you right click the Blender, open file location. So this will pop out. After this, you just right click this, right click. Properties, open file location. So when you see here, 2.83 is here, double click it, click the script, adds on. So here you need to copy this map model importer, copy and paste it here. Okay, paste it here. So this folder is here now. I already paste just now. Just copy this, paste it here. After that, open your Blender. This one, I close it. After you copy and paste to there, you need to restart your Blender. Close everything. And now Blender. I start the Blender. Now the first thing you need to do is you just need to delete these three objects. Select it, delete. So you check here, file, import, Google Map capture.rdc. See whether this one is here or not. If not here, if this one still not here, you need to come to edit, preferences. Here, you search map. To make sure this one, import, export, map, model, importer, you tick it. Make sure here tick already, then close it. Then here should have this. You also have a second method to install the plugin. The second method is you go to edit, preferences, install, then you select your desktop to find this one, desktop, double click it. After that, you search the name here, map. Also need to make sure this one tick it. Okay, once you see the import here, if here already have a Google Map capture, then everything already success. So now I can close the Blender already. This one I don't want to save. The next step, you need to create a Google Chrome shortcut. First, of course, you need to install the Google Chrome. You really need Google Chrome. We don't want the rest, like the Microsoft Windows Explorer, the Microsoft Edge, all this we don't want. We want the Google Chrome. Okay. You also can test with the Chromium. The Chromium. One of my friends test with the Chromium. It is success. Okay. But now I show you how to use the Google Chrome. First, you download the Google Chrome. After you download the Google Chrome, make sure your computer already have installed the Google Chrome. After that, what you need to do? After that, you need to close everything. Close everything. Here, you find the Google Chrome. Search the Google Chrome at here. Okay? The Google Chrome is here. You right-click. Find file location. So now you find the Google Chrome shortcut, you copy to your desktop 2 times, okay? Copy, here, right click, paste, right click, paste again, sorry. Paste once, after that you copy this, copy, then paste here. Okay, so now you have 2 copies of the shortcut. One, you remain as the original. This one, I can close it already. This one is the original. I can right-click to rename it so that I will know what is this. So, right-click, rename. This one, Google Chrome. Original. Ori. Now I know this is the original one. So, this one, Google Chrome, I name it RenderDoc. Okay, just follow this instruction. One is Google Chrome Ori, one is Google Chrome RenderDoc. So this one you remain it as a Ori. You can use it anytime. But for today's tutorial, we need this. We need to create a new shortcut. So I already give you a Google Chrome shortcut here. You need to copy and paste this one. So this shortcut I already put below the video description. So now, right-click the Google Chrome doc, this one, RenderDoc version, right-click, properties. So now this part, delete, okay, select all, Control-A to select all, then delete everything, make sure here empty already. Then copy my shortcut, this one, copy, Control-C to copy, and paste that here, Control-V. After that, click OK. So at this moment, you make sure all your Chromium, your Google Chrome, all close, all the browser, close all the browser. Make sure close all the browser. And now we test this Google Chrome RenderDoc, this one. This is a new shortcut that you just created, okay? So now we test it. If we double click it to open this, it will come out a black, a white color background with this. This one you click OK. After you click OK, it will pop out. Okay? I test it again. You double click it. If success, you will have a Google Chrome GPU, this one, whatever number, with a white background. After you click OK, it will open. So now, consider it success, then we close it. Close all the browser. Make sure no browsers here. So now you already finished install all the tools. Now we start to grab the map. The first step, you start the RenderDoc. In your RenderDoc, you need to click file. Okay, make sure this one you put on your right side, right hand side. You adjust it until a suitable size on your right hand side. Then you file, insert into process. And here you type Chrome, C-H-R-O-M-E, Chrome, then click refresh. After that, you double click your shortcut, open the shortcut that you just created, the one that you already modified, you double click it. At this moment, here, click refresh again. Here, find the Google Chrome GPU. Then, click inject. At this moment, back to this small conversation, click OK. So, you must be able to see all these white words with the black background. Must be. So, now, you can go to the Google Map. I already prepared the Google Map here. Copy. I paste that here. So now I want to search, for example, some of the 3D maps. I go to the United States of America. That is called Empire State Building. This is just an example. As demo, this is in New York City. Okay. So now you see the Empire State Building is at here. First, what you need to do, how to grab the 3D, you need to click the satellite. First step, click the satellite. Then, click the 3D. So now you can see the 3D already. You can even rotate this. Where is the Empire State Building? It's here. Okay, now I want to capture this 3D model and the surrounding as a demo. So what you need to do is you put your Google Chrome window at the left hand side and put your RenderDoc window in your left, in your right hand side, sorry. Here, you remove the 0, replace with 5. 5 seconds. So how to capture? After you click capture after delay, you immediately need to come here to move your 3D Google Map. You need to click and move. So now I demonstrate. Once here, already modified to 5 seconds, I click capture after delay, then come here, drag the map to move it in this way. Until here you can see capture already. So now this is the 3D. But this 3D we still cannot use it. This one I minimize it. I need to save this as demo. I save on my desktop. Right click, save. I save on the desktop. I name it, this is an RDC file. I name it Empire State Building. Then click save. Now open your Blender. The first thing you need to do is delete these three objects. We don't want this. Okay, just to select it, delete. After that, I assume you already installed this one, Google Map Capture. Just now you already installed. So now you just to import this RDC file by using this plugin. Import, again, file, import, Google Map Capture. This is on your desktop, so go to the desktop. Double click the Empire State Building. At this moment, your Blender will jam. Sometimes here it will show you no responding, but you just need to be patient and hold on for a while, wait for a while, rest for a while, and drink some water maybe. Okay, so here you need to wait for a while until the Empire State Building pop out. Maybe it take 1 minute, maybe it take a few seconds. It depends on your computer speed. Now it's on loading. Loading environment into your computer. Okay, now you see, the New York City already come out. So this is the New York City, and where is the Empire State Building? It's here. All the meshes already captured. So you see now this one selected, you can click this one so that you can see all the texture, to check the texture. Yes, this is New York City. It's perfect. It is beautiful and it is quite complete. The whole area in this window, the whole area already successfully captured. Empire State Building is here. Wow. This is New York City. It's here. So this is really awesome. Once you already import into Blender, of course you can export it out. Export as FBX file so that next time you still can use it. Just use it for fun. If you want to use it commercially, please refer to your lawyer, refer to your legal advisor, or refer to the terms and conditions of the Google Map. And this is just a demo, just for fun. Thank you for watching. If you love my video, if you love my tutorial, if you feel all this very helpful to you, then you can go to the bottom and click subscribe. Later, you also click the mini bell so that if next time I publish a new video, new tutorial, you will receive the notification immediately. Thank you. Go to the bottom of the video and click subscribe. Click the bell to receive all the notifications for every time I publish a new video and tutorial if you love it. If you find it helpful, I will keep on posting more and more tutorial for you. Life's it.